Okay, Cynthia, so Sam and I talked about putting some music on the background of these, and the first playlist I tried on his video was hilariously off. But we'll just go with it. If it's distracting, let me know. But it has to be royalty free, otherwise YouTube will not allow it. So we've got some on the minute cleaning jerks to begin with. Little forward in the dip there. Let's see if we can. So you see that you can see your forward in the split position as well, but the error is right here, right? Yeah, so a pretty common issue, obviously, but like that's what we need to focus on fixing. I think like for the most part, I asked you to like focus on transitioning like smoothly from the clean to the jerk. So I think that's where like maybe you're rushing a little bit. So obviously, like we want to like keep the time between the clean and the jerk the same every time. That was a little better. But not at the expense of the quality of the jerk. That's better. We still have a bit of a forward angle in the torso, right? So you're like this, whereas ideally it would be more like this, right? See how they look a little bit later on. Let's check out the positions of that clean. When you finish your clean, it's okay, I guess. Honestly, for the most part in those jerks, you need to focus on keeping your torso more upright in the receiving position. That was better. Yeah, okay. Some improvement there. So tired. I feel hot and dead. I feel help. Yeah. Okay, cool. We talked about your adductors. Like, I don't want to make your adductors stronger because your knees will come in more. Push presses. You dip straight on these. Do that, do it like that when you jerk. This is okay. The first set was really nice. This is a good example of like a more vertical push press, a more vertical dip. Let's see how these back squats are moving. Yeah, no issues there. Needs to come back a little. So, like, you want to try and keep the same, like, keep your knees this far forward all the way up until here, but you can see them coming back as you're shifting the load away from your knees and towards your hips. Like the more you can keep it with your legs, the stronger your quads will get. I think I mentioned before your pendulum rows, you need to start with the bar on the floor. What you're doing is a really great barbell row, but pendulum row, like when I say that, I'm specifying that I want the bar to start on the floor. Is a power snatch percentage of snatch max? Always is, always has been, unless I specify otherwise. I kind of fell into the bottom of the squat and lost all my attention and stability. Yeah, I don't know how much you managed to do that. Like an overhead squat's quite a controlled exercise. Like if you can do it on a snatch, you should have no problem doing it right on a, sorry, I'm trying to look at start position again, on an overhead squat. It's okay, like, if your shoulders went forward any more, then it would be too far forward, but, yeah, it's just about. Like, I can live with that, as long as it's consistent. I scooted back a little bit on the last rep, you fixed it. Okay, good. Yeah, nice. Turn the sound on. Yeah, it's good. Turn the sound on because I want to hear the timing. Yeah. Nice. Yeah, no issues with the power clean, so that's good. Wasn't snatch deadlift. You watch the video and you still feel like you're getting this wrong, okay. No, it's pretty good. That's what we want. Don't bounce the bar off the floor, right? Whenever you do a deadlift, we're practicing for snatch and clean and jerk, you don't get to bounce the bar off the floor on a snatch, so why would you do it on a snatch deadlift? Other than that, it's good. Great position. You came quite upright on that rep. We're trying to have this position where the shoulder's in front of the bar. So therefore you have to use your lat in order to sweep the bar backwards. Develop that upper back strength. Sorry, that lat strength. The ability to keep the bar close during the pull. Some snatches. Your start position here, right? I paused the video on those power snatches and said like you can't get any further forward than this. And then now we've like, if you look at the angle of your back here, it just seems a lot more horizontal than in the previous video. Just crank that chest up a little. Your actual relative position of your shoulders probably about the same, which suggests that the bars are different. Distance away from you, like it's not over the same part of your foot as it was before, so try and be consistent with that. I wonder if that's why your start position doesn't look consistent. Like if you're looking down on your foot, the bar should be over the same part of it every time. I wonder if we can compare that. It's not too different, I suppose. That was a good jerk. Sorry, I don't know. Sometimes it just takes forever to load these videos up. And I think this is the day that you felt really good. Good clean. Yeah, that forward lean again on that one. I actually want to look at the first one, because the first one felt nice. Yeah, you can see you're much more upright on that one. You still have... yeah, you see how the torso is generally like pretty upright. Shoulders pretty much above the hips, that's where we want to be. If you do them all like that, you'll have a much better time. I had a lot less hesitation this week that you did. I don't know why these are taking so long to load today, but they seem to go the second time, so maybe it's a bug. Easy clean. Great jerk to finish on, look at that. You're getting nice and upright. You can be tighter in the abs, like you're a little bit overextended through your back, but... okay, let's summarize. Snatches, be consistent with your start position. You always want to have your hips super high, so it needs to be lower than you think. Jerks, dip straight, receive the bar straight. Cleans look fine.